operating as a sterile assistant. So far what I have done, I've had my assistant go ahead and place the pack out. Everything has been cleaned in this room. The floor is always mopped every morning. I've already prepared our patients for surgery. I still scrubbed everything. Everything's always wiped down. They've already started the opening of the pack. They open it in such a way that the last thing I do is I pull the last flap away from me. As you can see right here, we have our indicator strip saying that wasn't the autoclave. You know, the pack is last autoclaved on 4/115 by MP, who's one of our lovely assistants. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish opening, set up the sterile field, so our surgeon can come in and do the surgery. Okay. So I'm going to pull the last flap away from me. Slide everything a little bit closer because I'm a little short. And the biggest thing is that I don't want to break sterility, so I need to make sure that I don't touch anything that is unsterile. So in my pack, I have all my instruments, the towel clamps, my OK strip, my drape. I always want to lay out my instruments in order of what I think he's going to want to use first. So some gauze, this could probably be a little bit bloody. And then I want to set my tray in the back, my blade holder, needle drivers, scissors, got my mayos and my medicine balls. Alice tissue forceps probably won't be needed for this procedure. Two pairs of bigger hemostats. If I could have Nicole open my blade for me, that would be awesome. Just grab a ten blade. See it? A ten blade? Close your hands. So everything is set up for him to come in. So at this point what I'm going to do is I will go ahead and drape in our patient. Like I said before, that leg is sterile, so I will go ahead and do everything again. So now that we have that all together, Dr. Boone will come in and start his part.